So the question states that my friend had clinical depression, unfortunately committed suicide. Did they die as a disbeliever? And in general, no. The person that commits suicide is still buried with the Muslim, meaning the Muslim that commits suicide, even though it's a grave sin, without doubt, they are buried with the Muslims. And, you know, inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. Allah's forgiveness and mercy is more than what we could, you know, comprehend. So it's not for us to restrict something that is, by definition, absolute. However, the question also adds that the person was clinically depressed, and you know, Allahu A'lam, what kind of impact that has on one's decision making, whether it's a chemical type of depression where you know they're really just not themselves. One might even be able to argue or to go as far as to say that inshallah they'll be forgiven completely because they were not, you know, within their normal stasis, you know, their normal state. So I think we should approach this. I mean, it's very sad, so I'm sorry for the loss. You know, it's very unfortunate. I think depression and mental health issues and suicide contemplation and suicide itself is a grave problem, particularly in the West. I don't want to downplay that. And we need to have more compassion with people that have those type of inclinations and those urges and help them through it. So I think we should take this as an opportunity to look at it that way, rather than, you know, be concerned, oh, this person's a disbeliever or you know, in the hellfire or something like that. It's not for us to say, inshallah, we ask Allah's mercy for us and for them, inshallah. Wallahu a'lam.